Let us continue in worship and we come to the reading of scripture. Kare bele panda na ka uvala fungo la mzimu. Sazera amba ka uyu mwezi wa February une vanje vamba nga lufuno. Rori dose za ka wimbo ro imbo imbo ngosha ngo ngosha dzingosha. That is Song of Songs in the Old Testament, Song of Songs. So last time we read up until chapter 6, verse 3. There's a mistake there. It's supposed to be chapter 6, verse 4. Chapter 6, verse 4. And we read chapter 7 as well, and chapter 8. These two chapters basically contain two songs. Nyimbo mbili. Holy Mbolunga, Una Nyimbo, Zonoshika 6, and Vangwari Ndushpida, 6. So, apaka chapter 6. Verse 4 to chapter 8, verse 4, Nurumuri Imbo, chapter 8, verse 5 to 14, the Chumachikita Kananurumuri Imbo. But we will combine and we will read them together, or we'll look at them together. So, Ndukubara Ndukushumisa, Bibili Yashukua, Yendafara, you will listen and follow along in your Bibles. Song of Songs, Ngosha Yazungosha, Imbo Imbo, Isislamelo, Sisislamelo. So chapter 6 from verse 4, it says, "You are beautiful as Tirzah, my love, lovely as Jerusalem, awesome as an army with banners. Turn away your eyes from me, for they overwhelm me. Your hair is like a flock of goats leaping down the slopes of Gilead. Your teeth are like a flock of eels that have come up from the washing, all of them bear twins. Not one among them has lost its young. Your cheeks are like halves of pomegranate behind your veil. There are 60 queens and 80 concubines and virgins without number. My dove, my perfect one, is the only one of her mother, pure to her who bore her. The young women saw her and called her blessed, the queens and concubines also, and they praised her. Who is this who looks down like the dawn, beautiful as the moon, bright as the sun, awesome as an army with banners? I went down to the nut orchard to look at the blossoms of the valley, to see whether the vines had budded, whether the pomegranates were in bloom. Before I was aware, my desire set me among the chariots of my kinsman, a prince. Return, return, O Shulamite. Return, return, that we may look upon you. Why should we look upon the Shulamite as upon a dance between two armies?" Chapter 7. "How beautiful are your feet in sandals, O noble daughter. Your rounded thighs are like jewels, the work of a master hand. Your navel is a rounded bowl that never lacks mixed wine. Your belly is a heap of wheat encircled with lilies. Your two breasts are like two forms, twins of a gazelle. Your neck is like an ivory tower. Your eyes are pools in Heshbon by the gate of Bat Rabim. Your nose is like a tower of Lebanon, which looks towards Damascus. Your head crowns you like Carmel, and your flowing locks are like purple. A king is held captive in their tresses. How beautiful and pleasant you are, O loved one, with all your delights. Your stature is like a palm tree, and your breasts are like its clusters. I say I will climb the palm tree and lay hold of its fruit. Oh, may your breasts be like clusters of the vine, and the scent of your breath like apples, and your mouth like the best wine. It goes down smoothly for my beloved, gliding over lips and teeth. I am my beloved, and his desire is for me. Come, my beloved, let us go out into the fields and lodge in the villages. Let us go out early to the vineyards and see whether the vines are budded, whether the grape blossoms have opened and the pomegranates are in bloom. There I will give you my love. The mandrakes give forth fragrance, and beside our doors are all choice fruits, new as well as old, which I have laid up for you, O my beloved." Chapter 8. "Oh, that you were like a brother to me, who nursed at my mother's breast. If I found you outside, I would kiss you and none would despise me. I would lead you and bring you into the house of my mother, she who used to teach me. I would give you spiced wine to drink and the juice of my pomegranate. His left hand is under my head and his right hand embraces me. I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, that you not stay up or awake in love until it pleases. Who is that coming up from the wilderness, leaning on her beloved? Under the eagle tree I awakened you. There your mother was in labor with you. There she bore you. She who bore you was in labor. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death. Jealousy is fierce as the grave. Its fleshes are fleshes of fire, the very flame of the Lord. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If a man offered for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly despised. We have a little sister, and she has no breast. What shall we do for our sister on the day when she is spoken for? If she is a wall, we will build on her a battlement of silver. But if she is a door, we will enclose her with boards of cedar. I was a wall, and my breasts were like towers. Then I was in his eyes, as one who finds peace. Solomon had a vineyard at Baal Hamon. He let out the vineyard to keepers. Each one was to bring for its fruit 1,000 pieces of silver. My vineyard, my very own, is before me. You, O Solomon, may have 1,000, and the keepers of the fruit 200. O, you who dwell in the gardens, with companions listening for your voice, let me hear it. Make haste, my beloved, and be like a gazelle or a young stag on the mountains of spices. Amen. Tesatuyapanda karimbe verse 1 and 2 yawimbolo nori uthando luka baba. Let's sing verse 1 and 2 of that song. The love of the father is deep like the sea.
Uthando luka baba lunje olwandle bolo wathi lujulile luyazeka yimipho lwafinyelela kimi ngisezonene zami alwazana ngindlula
Musorobarapa, having read in Song of Songs, as we said, this month we look at this book in the Bible. Yes, in the world we talk of love, we hear about love, but it's good that we listen to God's word, we listen to the Bible. What does it say about love? And in reading this section, let us focus on chapter 8, verse 4, and verse 6, and verse 7. I repeat those verses, chapter 8, verse 4, it says, I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, that you not stay up or awake in love until it pleases. Verse 6, set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death, jealousy is fierce as the grave, its fleshes are fleshes of fire, the very flame of the Lord. Verse 7, many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If a man offered for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly despised. In reading with you this passage, what we learn is that love is beautiful and powerful. Rufuno Durabudi Ronaka Runamanda. When you talk of love, sometimes you wonder or you ask, is love something you can control or is it something that controls you? Rufuno Nichituchine Vachiranga Kana Nichituchine Chitovaranga. You end up sometimes doing things and you say no, it's love. Or you fall in love. Tira, you fall in love. You just fell. You're walking and then you fall in love. You didn't get in love. You didn't love, but sometimes you just fell in love. So sometimes you find people talking like that. Yes, love is powerful and it captures or it influences the whole person, the mind, the heart, the body. And that is what we also see here. As we said from the beginning, this book, Song of Songs, it is celebrating love. Love between man and woman. Romantic love, eros, marital love. It is a book that talks about the coming together of a man and a woman. And it is not shy to talk about man and woman, sexual relation in marriage. And in so doing, it is teaching us that before God, love, sex, marriage is a good thing. It's a wonderful thing. And God who gave us life, who gave us body, who gave us feeling, who gave us desire, who gave us heart, who gave us ability to love, is also giving us the way, the right way. And it is important also to read this book, knowing that this love between man and woman in marriage is reflecting of God's love for his people. The Bible talks many places of God's relationship with his church as a relationship between husband and wife. We have read also Ephesians chapter 5, Jesus loving the church. It's what husbands must do to their wives. Wives loving their husbands or respecting their husbands is what the church, or is reflected in what the church must do in respect of its head, Jesus Christ. So in this section, we continue to hear about the power and the beauty of love. And it is something which we must listen to, because as we said, even in this world, in these times, we find that there are a lot of wrong things. Wrong things happening around us. Wrong things happening to us. Wrong things that we do in the name of love in this area of relationship, sex, and marriage. And because of the corrupted view, we end up sometimes talking about love, sex, and marriage as a bad thing, as something which is painful, as something which brings hate. And that's one of the reasons why we read in the book of Song of Songs, where you find a celebration. Love which is beautiful, love which is also powerful. And that is what we must see in this passage. Now, the first thing which we must understand when we talk of love, beautiful and powerful, is that love does not only capture eyes and heart or feelings, but it is something which is sealed with covenant or with commitment. Rechambanga ufuno, bibili ikorusumbeza hapore, asimakungo pezi yaure, nofashiwa mato, nofashiwa mbilo, zuko takaza, mara ufuno, runa uvopa mranga, runa ukwakisa, runa udimekeza, kaubahone amranga. Chapter 8, verse 6. Bapa, uchuko imbiwa, reset me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm or your hand. Ukwambu wangachika. Yes, mbeeni mbiluni. Mara, nibe na chika. Kachanda. Nude vila zune afi. Put a ring on my finger. Ara nukwambu ni mfuna. ndimbiruni yanu kandi zvibone zvive khagara. And this talk, this kind of talk, yes, it's about expressing love which is come from the heart. It's about making it official, public, sealing kana kuzvikwatisa waita nanga chiga chiga chine chakwamba kukwata hazviitwi. And if tovune muthu kuzviimba, especially wachifumakadzi hapo, ngorisazoramba mukuimba wachifumakadzi, the woman sometimes haimba wamunna, and you find that it's even from the woman. Put as me as a seal in your heart, but also put a seal as a seal even on your arm. And if tovune ndokori rezvibone sapfunzo ya bibili, mapungwa ufuno ana commitment ana udinekedza ana mbovo. Zvino ndifutuvune zvakutoma kubva ka chapter 6 verse 4 nosvika ka chapter 6 verse 10, where you see that in chapter 6 verse 4 and 5 muthu ukovona ukovona muthu, the man is singing, singing about the woman, the lady, the bride. Ukokonovona sazvinoratidza kudiva, the eyes or the ears are like gate, are like a door inside you or to the heart or to the mind. And in verse 6 and 7 you find him continuing to sing, that there is detail that he's singing about your teeth, ukofanyisa na sheep coming down or ngudzonokovota nzvimbo, even the cheeks behind the veil, is able to notice that detail. Verse 8 and 9, there are many queens, concubines, virgins, unavazana vanje. Mara verse 9 he says, my dove, my perfect one, is the only one of her mother. Unaunanga, unaufokasa, directing that love to one person. And also verse 4 and 10, when he sees the woman, otudzanya hani umufanyisa na mbi, an army with banners, ndore the mbi soldiers wambara uniform botama and all that, but also talking about the moon, the sun and the dawn. So it is something which is showing this man, this husband, this groom, captured ukofuniwa kana ukofuna nga mulandu wazvo yabona nga zvine yakuhungura bawana achi ambanga lufuno rune avana. Now when you read this song, you might ask, if maybe you are not yet married, how will I see, how will I love the right person? Or how will I be noticed? How will someone come to love me? Mara ndifuto zvine namusi rina mbudziso dzononga hedzo. Rasifanire ujaya. Vatu vafanira kututuwedzwa kusajaya kana to rush. Kamusi wavo bvanda nḓira uri kandi notisiwe, kandi tode muthu. Mara zvichikono imbiwa hafa ka Song of Songs, it is also because God, who is the owner of life, life is under his control. We must also know that even the matters of the heart, relationship, love and marriage are also under his control. And for example, if you read in Proverbs, Mirero chapter 8, Proverbs chapter 8, each kwamba also about the wisdom that a person has, but it admits, I can't know everything, I can't understand everything. And one of the things you can't understand is outcome. For example, Proverbs 30, verse 18 and 19, it says, there are three things that are too wonderful for me, four I don't understand. Verse 19, the way of an eagle in the sky, the way of a serpent on a rock, the way of a sheep on the high seas. and the way of a man with a virgin. Kana ndile yampanga achitoda musidzana. So it is talking about not knowing everything, not knowing the outcome, but admitting that there is one who is above everything, who is in control. The timing, the people coming together, being attracted, knowing each other, continuing in love, in relationship and marriage. It is something which God is able to give. It's one of the things that God can give and bless with. And when you know that, it is something which helps a person to be comforted, not to be anxious or worried, but to know that God directs us. Even those who are already in marriage, you who are already in marriage, it is something to also remember. It is God who directed you. Because imagine, even if I was to make example of those who are married here, I don't think you were born in the same place. You're not born in the same place. Yeah. Yeah, so Mara, you find people coming from far, different background, but coming together, seeing and having attraction, having connection, having love. It is a wonder. It is a blessing. And it is something to thank God about. But also when we talk of this way of love, it's not just about desire. The song is not just talking of desire, feelings, emotions, but it talks of commitment. Many people talk of love as a game. That's why we're just connecting. We're not going anywhere. We're just jolly. We're just taking a jolly. We're like taking a stroll. We're just walking. But where are you going? No, we're just jolly. We're just enjoying each other. And you find that there is no talk of love in the way this song and the Bible is talking about. Where even the woman is able to say, set me as a seal on your heart and set me as a seal on your hand. And even this talk of a seal, kana ruswayo, it is also reminding of protection. Not just confirmation, not just making things sure. Mukano kwatisa zvitu. Marakava dombura arirokotanga neza chipackage, yo delivery wa package, kana ndichipiwa a gift, it is sealed. It is protected. And this is something which we must take seriously, whereby even when you talk of love or year of love from this song, it is something which keeps us safe. Jesus of Jola, Ujena Uva, Mutanga Fanisana, Nazi Badas, South Africa. Zine, now the rain is rained, it's just potholes. Vangovanova Venda comes in Uma, Erebodu, the Sorrow of Janana, because the road is swept away. But you can be, we go to God. Nambiru ya salo yonzo kwa migodi godi. Nambiru yonzo kwa migodi godi ngori. It's casual relationship. Nuso kwa jola. O doweliwa kana. Nambiru yo dowela zene. But we must know, beloved, kerekia muna washu. Mudzimu wa mranga. The covenant making God is giving us a model regarding love, regarding connection. Una commitment. Una wita mranga. God doesn't just say, I love you, I will do this for you. But he is God who made a covenant. He is God who bind himself. And that is what makes us to be safe, to be secure. Even when we look at ourselves, how did God love us? Because we have nothing impressive that we can impress God with. You will also remember Uralimbo, Hakiliche, Kilimubi, ke le a gese hang re di tsinengisa araba etsa dini ke ratwa ja jo ke mohlolo. It's a wonder that I'm able to be loved by God who choose us even though we are sinners to call you, unite you to Jesus, giving you faith, giving you to be born again, giving you the Holy Spirit. You are a life wa kutshilo busapeli. It's a wonder and it is something which we must know and remember. Richamba ngarufuno wa mzi. For example, in Deuteronomy chapter 7, Deuteronomy chapter 7, when you look from verse 6 to 9, the Israelites are being reminded that now they are going into Canaan. And the question is, how did God love you and bless you like this? Is it because you were better than others, more in number than others? And the answer is no. But it is God who loved you and he made a covenant from Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. You are descendants of Jacob. But the point is that it's God's decision. And God did not just promise, hey, ndiyanifuna, kari chimbile rote. Maraba wana mzimu o chimbile nabo, aba jenisa kanana. Mzimu wa amba, and he went and did what he said he would do. And that is the message of the Bible. Mzimu achiri ndiyanifuna. Hako chimbile na inui, hapa shanguni pezi. Mara una uchimbira uya une abahone. Kaho alini na lii, the eternal glory, the eternal life. And that is what gives assurance. Ratutuweza na rine ufuna mzi. And even when you talk about loving God, ufuna mzi. Yes, love him with your heart. Mara it's not just words. Mara chifono lukono ambasa unoyu, kono kambaka 8 verse 6. Mzi muromu beambiruni. But also we make commitment to God. It is not just, oh, wow, God, I love you. Hey, God, you make me joyful. Wara, wara, fili, fili, notakara. But there's no commitment. It's just talk. And that's why we must also not just question our understanding of love. How am I loving my spouse? But also, how am I loving God? Is it real love? Is it strong love? Is it beautiful love? Which involves commitment, which involves covenant. Where God is saying, you are part of the covenant. I want to make marriage with you as my church. What is your response? Pinulu yangu ndio ri mini. Ndio ri ena. Sasula mtu achukwa mbisiwa. Mtu akwa dama. Ari, will you marry me? What is your response? And also when you talk of that, that is what also makes love beautiful, but at the same time, because we are sinners, it also makes love painful. Or when there is unfaithfulness, people being not being loyal. And that's what God also knows. He's hurt, he's angered, even when we, whom he loves, gave us his son, giving us eternal life, giving us this earth and blessings on life, in life, but we don't love him. It hurts, it angers God. But you see, Ayani, Bible, Ezekiel, when you reach home in your own time, when you read the chapter of Ezekiel, chapter 16, where God is comparing himself to a young man who saw a girl with nothing. Amuitela zvote. Amuvisa yabahone. Bawana ono naka. Ono vera panda. Mara hoyo musidzana kana hoyo musadzi. She then goes to other men. And God was talking about Judah and Israel, whom he loved, he blessed, he did many things for them. And he bind himself to them. But what did they do? They reject God. They go to other religions, to other gods, using even the things that God has given them, the blessings zine mudzimo vapa. Bawana dzichiko jiwa uyo shumela mimwe midzi. Bawana mudzima kwamba ngau pfa vhuṱungu ngau kwata ende zwithu zwine ra khou zwi humbula na hanefha kha verse 6 hu tshi ambiwa nga lufuno nga jelasi nga u kwata zwi khou vha hone huṅwe na ngauri zwe vhathu ra fulufhedzisa vha wana ri sa khou zwi ita u tshinyala hashu ha u tshinya zwithu zwa mudzimu kana lufuno lwe mudzimu ri ronaka. But the second thing which we see here when we talk of love as beautiful and powerful, it involves desire and sexual emotions that can get out of control when not handled right, when handled without God's involvement. Musi richiko tetele sapo kwa mbonga ufuno une unazwipfi zwa kudzekani une zwinga kunda muthu zwa disa muchinyaro arali risa kupfa mudzimu richiko ita nga nḓila yashu. And that is what we see or made clear, especially when we read from chapter 6, verse 11, until chapter 8, verse 4. Uneka chapter 8, verse 4. Heyo section ya kopezi seranga kuri. Bewa wananjana wa Jerusalem. Nisongo vusa ufuno. Don't awaken love until it so desires or until it is the right time. But also chapter 8, verse 6 and 7. It compares death or love to death, love to fire. Even verse 7, it talks of water. Now, as we mentioned, or as you know, fire, water is a good thing. Ngamuliro, we can able to get warm and cook. But fire is dangerous. It can get out of control and destroy. Water is good. We drink, we wash, we water the plants to grow. But as we see in the past 2 weeks, there can be floods where you find people drowning, buildings destroyed. It is talking about the force, the power of love, where there is also desire for the other person. It can go out of control, but God who created us, ori tabatu, na zene zo zwipfi, zo funa, zo todo funiwa, zo kzeka. It comes from God, but then he arranges that also there be marriage. Difunto unera fondo konozi, not unguluzi wona hapa, but to know even from what the Bible teaches. When you look at chapter 6, verse 11 and 12, bawana wamsitzana ako imba, she's like daydreaming, thinking about a lover. But then the dream kind of takes her where she ends up in a place where she didn't intend. Petu yaba asongo plana kuyahona, showing the possibility ya uri zwithu zwiyathoma muhumbuloni in mind. Mara mapeseroni mawana sazune ya kuhamba ka verse 12, before I was aware, my desire set me among the chariots of my kinsman, a prince. But also verse 13, where others are calling this mushromite kana petunia vahone shurama, come back so that we look at you, so that ribone runakura. Maranaibuka verse 13, wamuna bako budzisa, or why should you look upon the Shulamite as upon a dance before two armies? So ngabang maifi, una urikari, rekoto dobo ona mutu. Onaka hani, how beautiful she is. But then, una, ezu nunga chukobari, to make a sex object. Auna toni, una ushumisa mutu, for utakaza zwipfi zwawo, to objectify a person as an object to satisfy my sexual feelings. Bawana zutuvne wokusumbedzwa yo possibility. Mara then richi jenaka chapter 7, verse 1 to 5. Wamuno kokoda wamsazi, the groom is praising the bride. And we have read this kind of poem. A poem ineba wana mutwako koda detail. Chimwana chimu uchikfanyisa na ichi. Sahluleka kushubona ka chapter 7 verse 1 to 5. We saw it in chapter 4 verse 1 to 7. But here in chapter 7 verse 1 to 5 bakumubona uko thoma pasi kamirenje zurumbi kundu uko yamtha apetsera katho is praising. It's not a picture of what is beautiful. Mara ndi mtu anokori, you are beautiful to me. You are beautiful for me. And this praise continues, verse 6 to 9, where it talks of even desiring to be with his bride or his beloved. Divine Hunaba Koshubona from verse 6, how beautiful and pleasant you are. Akumamba Samuri, akumamba Urgunami Chero, Ditomeniga Gonyandana. And you see the desire, the thinking of another person leading to sex, leading to thinking of sex, the coming together of a man and woman. You remember also in Genesis chapter 2, verse 24 and 25, when Adam was presented with Eve, oh, flesh of my flesh, bone of my bones, they were naked without shame. They became one flesh. They come together. And it is something which we see here, that it is a possibility. Kauri desire. Iko trauma kaubona. Una uungura. Zuko isa kauzeka. Zuko isa kautangana amuna na msazi. And it is something which is not wrong if it is in marriage. That's what the Bible is saying. There's nothing wrong with it. And that's why even from verse 10 to 13, the woman even responds, inviting the man. I am my beloved, and his desire is for me. Verse 11, are come, my beloved. Let us go to the fields. But this whole section, it is showing that as human beings, we have desire. And this desire can be aroused. We must watch out for that. There are actions that lead to other actions. Satsumbu, rukamba pango wabona. But when you see, we are watching a lot of things. The Instagram, the Facebook, but when we chambara wa manuadu. Umwera, fisukanaka pornograph. Rekomono ngari vdo gumane, it will just end seeing. No. Yes, it affects the mind. But it is also a gateway, a starting point, ba wana fituzuchu operera. Ka action. Namusi, watu wadwane wakubuzi sauri, is kissing and hugging wrong? Watu wakubuzi sa, azungo kake ukisa, azungo kake hugging. Yeah, you can argue it's not wrong. But there are actions that men and women do that arouse feelings, that arouse imagination, and that lead to action coming together of men and women. And especially even in today's world where we are talking of sexual harassment. Sometimes people are just getting used to huggy hug, kiss kiss. And we end up harassing others. Utsikele zabamu. Uzita kabamwe. Ngauri wodhola zvenezvo. Ukolangiwa nga zvipi. And that's why it's important also to talk of boundaries. Hapa atifuki. Mara also ngori hapa atifuki. As well before ndifanda sendera tsini na mkano. You know that this thing can fall. This is the end. It doesn't mean that I must put the glass there. Eh? You must put it back one here. What do I mean? Una usendera kure. Una usendera kure. Mara ngori mdzimu ozviita. Oita na mbingano. Oita uri. Ndizvitu zvine zvaitwa mbinganoni. And we must not be ashamed to talk about that. That's what the Bible talks about. This is what this song is singing about. Arabasa uzdivi chukwamba. Ngadzi go deeper wine. Ngao deeper michero. The fruits and all that. Do you think he's talking? Ngao batu wako lisa na ziyogati beziaba. Not the strawberry. It's not talking of that. It's a picture. It's a poem. It's talking about people kissing each other, loving each other, touching each other, hugging each other, and it leads to that. And we must not be afraid to talk of that. Even teaching the children, You must not play with fire. And that's why even in chapter 8, the girl then sings, knowing that there is this danger of this desire not only leading to sex, but also zungasoliwa. Look at verse 1. If you were my brother, I would hug you. We'll walk hand in hand, and nobody will have a question. Verse 2. I will bring you into my mother's room or house. In other words, there are spaces, private spaces. There's nothing wrong. Maras, you know, because we are not married. Una zungu spaces ne arikono jenisa na kazo. Rabari, ribabili pezi. Una zungu zupinga, sometimes which, no, we can't be together. If we are not married. Because there is danger. Danger of arousal. Desire being awakened. Bawana, machero, not only upomje, but also even rape happening. Sexual assault or sexual misconduct. And that's why in chapter 8, verse 4, Bawana, this section is ending by saying, watch out. I charge you, daughters of Jerusalem. Don't arouse love when it is not the time. And as I'm saying, the Bible is saying there's nothing wrong with love. There's nothing wrong with sex. There's nothing wrong with marriage. It is a gift, a blessing from God. Food and drink. Jewels. Comes in. But the problem, we as people, how do we handle the blessings of God, the gifts that God has given us? Has intended. And that's why this song of songs, it is able to sing about love, sex, and marriage as part of God's word. We must be prepared to hear from the Creator who gave you the body, who gave you the heart, who gave you sexual emotion and feeling. He is the Lord of all of life. But sometimes we think we are clever. We are more wise than God. No, God, we don't want you in this area. In my relationship life, sex life, thinking life, I don't want you here. When I have a problem, that's when God, I call you, oh, come and help me. No. When we say Jehovah is Lord, is King, the owner who owns you, who owns the earth and everything in it, what does he say? And that's why we find in Song of Songs a song like this, a message like this. And it is important as people when we understand also ourselves. Yes, we have flesh, we have mind, we have heart, we have desires, we have emotions. But it doesn't mean that we can be out of control. Number one, that's why God has given you a mind to reason. Not just to follow desire, feelings. Therefore, I do as the flesh wants. No, there is mind as well. When you are a believer, God gives you new life, new birth. No bebwanga uswa, ni pwana muyamkeetwa. Who is able also, as one of the fruit of the Spirit, to give you self-control. Self-control over the power or the desires of the flesh. But you will find in today's world, not just today, but even before, the devil, Satan, no. But live as you feel. Italinga une na fanga. Nisongo di zima zwipi. Nisongo di tivera. Go ahead and do as you desire. Nobody can stop you. Don't listen to anyone. Umwe mutu abachukori, I'm powerless. I'm powerless. I can't do anything. Karzogojia, Ndikashangoleneli, today's world where there is a lot of sexual pictures around me, a lot of people doing sexual immorality. How can I not do it? I'm raising children here in Gauteng. I'm raising children in 2020, 2021. It's a fallen world. Obipa. Did they turn? Maramuzimu kori. Na musi zobipa ngoraro. It's not something where we must then go and say, hi, Muzimu, we failed. We can't do it. But when verse 6 talks of the fire, even the flame of the Lord, it is comparing, yes, love with fire. But there is also God's power. Yes, love, desire, emotions, they can be powerful. But there is also God's power, which is available for you, available to you. When you come to Jesus, when you come to His Word, it has power to change you, to give you power to self-control, to say no, to be patient, to wait. Nakale ishango line ahuna oluwambo. And it is something which we must preach as gospel, as truth of God. But the last thing, love is beautiful and powerful. Love involves desire that connects people, brings benefit not just to individual, but also to society and other people. Rufuno, rukotanganya vatu. Not beziva tu wabili. Mara una vangu vare involved in this process. Ya ufuna na abene wabili. Even in the process of marriage, it's not just benefiting the man and the woman, but the song, they are also involved. They are also to benefit, but also to protect or to guide uri nga khazo hezwine mudzimo ita zvibvelere houbuti harufuno zvive zvithu zvine zvava hone huna vane mudzimo vavea uri pavone. And that's what we see from chapter 8 from verse 5 to 14. When you look at verse 5, it is talking even of the mother. Hoyu musidzana huna hune abva hone huna mme omubeba. The man admits and acknowledges that she comes from a family. She comes from, there are parents. Mara una unechu mshpinga urufuno urusa kuchimbi zwazone. When love is not handled well, parents, they must not be involved. Hey, it must be a secret. It must be a secret. Mother and father must not know. Then you ask yourself, why? Most times, there is something wrong happening. Kanwa koto vunkaneza. Most times, why are you not involving parent and mother and father? It's like, no, I want to talk about zima rufuno. Ara rufuno lo kuma vanga siku dzinji. Ara rufuno lo rwabudi vato tutuwedza. Ara li ndiya dovoro huna ba baby vasi vabudi, mara in normal case, kotsi mme, they want to see their daughter getting married. Kanezo. Mbolika ni banja vatu wa vipi, kati shirela mshie. Mara mse kosa za marati ilioso. You want your child to be married, to have good marriage, to have me. And Fonika, kose. Mothers want that, fathers want that. So it is something which God has given us, parents, to guide us. Even in the process of love, two people coming together. It's not just two people. Let's do our own thing. We must not tell others. We must not involve others. No. But there is involvement even of parents. That's why they are mentioned here. The other thing which you see, verse 8 and 9. Ka o ka ulimbo. Verse 8 and 9, ukwambwanga ngatsikarats. The brothers are saying, we have a little sister. Kaj venda unamwane tunga mamu. So she's still young, she's still growing up. They are concerned about their welfare. They are concerned about their safety. They are concerned about their future. The brothers are representing not just the physical brothers of the girl, of the sister, but it involves the parents, the family, the community, even the church, guardians, guiding the young girl, the youth to grow. And also, now there is time to be involved in zvinhu zvarufuno. Una chipinga chaujena musi richamba zvarufuno rukwamba zvambingano. Richamba zvambingano rukwamba zvakudzekana. Ane tusvika. Asi zvavo. Mara yo. Namusi azvichambomura. Azvichambomura. 13 years, 14 years, jena nikazvo. Last year there was even proposals that even in the school curriculum vana va primary school vafanele kufundziwa zvito zvononga zvezva kudzeka uri hani vasati va clear mara it was not this ideal from the Bible uri habe huna chipinga chauti jenisa ka zvito zvakudzekani zvambingano zvarufuno anito aruwa anito swika but you find today ikozvinyadza mara ndituwedza vacho mudzimu kwamba nakone namusi namusi rikadhiya rusa vana vakadhiya vatuko namusi richikwamba sakereke richikofanira kutuwedzana kari togomere kari tsireredze uri vana vonokwaluwa kama kungwa zvakudzekana rituwedze uri chipinga chitofika but not only vana vadzijenise kazvakudzekani kana vasongo dzijenise kazvakudzekana but it's also talking to us today when there is abuse sexual abuse of children. The people who are supposed to protect, closing the door, closing the wall, are actually the ones who are now the dangerous ones. When they want to find out terrorists, who caught the woman, the cards, who are now one of the ones, they are the danger. And if you say, Rafa no one has, Tomana Kirikini, Mitani Ashu, Marnaka Shango, because that's not the ideal that God is giving us. That's not the truth that God is giving us. Risara kovai sabamu. Now damage ava. Machero. Bawa nona the consequences which are not good, which are painful. Even for future relationships. But not only that. Na panda mzi. Aba uri arungo ita. Zwe mzimu arivechera zwa. Zwe mzimu arivizera zwa. Bukoti. Vanna zikarazi. Nifutu vunera fano roko nobona. Visirias kauri. Women who really are protect. And one of me, else to Rafano to two words. Who protector, Naba baby, Vashawu Savana, Baba go to two words. Obviously, yes, the world, there is internet, there is phone, there is TV, and all that. Uno phone Ropata, Zimbond, Uno phone Robert Zilimit, Chimuchpinga, Namana Wamuza, a phone young guy did to many check. Koimo, who put this up with the Zatu, who put ifunicha ukwamba nani ngorona una vathu vonoko shumisa webu dza internet mwana onotswiwa mwana onokungiwa onoisiwa kazvitozvo zvamuri ndimushumo kune rafano uita mara ndimushumo nemudzima korumidza uita richifungupera n mara arali vasokochira as if no it's safe mwana otosoko aruwa chifungona babe unosoko mulonga re no my child will just grow utoso kwa ruwa naone kana ndikomuisa kerekeni ndikomuposa chikoroni no parents must also be involved in the growth of their children but the other thing verse 11 and 12 bawana ukwambiwa hoyo wamthanga ane ange murao runo dzivona kutonga mulisa it's like a shepherd but now he seems saying that verse 11 and 12 Solomon has got a lot of things has got a lot of vineyards una tsimunji una michelo minji. There are people who take care of his vineyards. Maraka verse 12 are my vineyard, my very own is before me. Obviously, I'm going to give you a kwambo, Solomon kwambo fi una basadzi vanje. In history, he had a lot of women and like that. But this shepherd lover is saying, no, I've got one, my own one vineyard, my own one woman, and it's enough for me. But it's not only talking of that. It's also talking about Solomon who is rich, who is powerful, and he's got a lot of things. And it's in a world where he is assured that even though Solomon is rich and having this kind of money, he has his wife, he has his bride. Amadoda atswiwa. Children of Solomon, that's a blessing. You will come see what the Gidim and the best girl. No more than a very young lady. I will run here. Then comes into talk on the KFC base, but we are going to be sent. I know the sentence is him. Kula Dubai. Anga Kokoza. Angan Jair. The Susne. Oh, you walk on him with that assurance that no, I'm not going to compare myself to be like Solomon. Also, God has given me this vineyard. I'll take care of it. I will love her. I'm satisfied with her. And una ukwata, una assurance that I continue with life na eitsimu yang. And it is something, as we read in chapter 8, something to remember that obviously, for example, when you talk of Solomon and this shepherd lover, una zilevele za chelede, chumushpinga chelede za konda, there are challenges of money and all that. Should it end the relationship? Should it end love? Should it end the marriage? But when you talk of the beauty and love and power of love, even those kind of situations, una go Solomon, you will come say, aungi Solomon, love is beautiful. It flourishes, not just survives, it can grow. Bawana una upudi. Chopezi sera, 13 and 14, when the song comes to an end, the husband is like among others. But then he talks of his voice. Let me hear it. Verse 14, make haste, my beloved. Be like a gazelle. To talk together. There are things that happen rina bangana, rina mishumo, bawana rekoya udi entertainanda. Mara, una udipewa also nanga haya. Arali wofiwa mbinga, bana muna, bana msazi, una udipewa ngoba hayani. Na mtu wao, not just outside with your friends, not just outside with colleagues or relatives, but also the activity at home. And it is also important, even as parents, raising up children. Yes, there are things that we are busy with, but also we need to be close, to have activities, to talk to each other. And most importantly also, even when we talk of God, our relationship with God, we need to hear His voice. Renga se expecto vera panda, richi diva rufuno romziin. Listening to God. This is like a love letter. This is like a love letter. Babu Nazula, Uchuko Laberera, phone, or Ijene, Uskutoko says, Dene, I want to rabbi you. You are expecting your lover to call, to talk, to send a message. Here is the message from God saying, I love you. Saying, you are my lover, my beloved. And if tuzune, muzimu, muzirichivara ifilawe, we can see and understand his love that is strong, his love that is beautiful, his love that never ends, which is steadfast, his love which is sure. Nothing can separate us from the love of Jesus. But once we don't have time to listen to God, to listen to the Bible, to be in the Bible, then we come with doubt, asking, does God love me? Is His love enough? But we ask that because we don't know. Marabashu ndi chipedzisa, ndi mafungo anenda kuri kare tutuwedze. Kauri, richisedza, richihumbura, zvarufuno, zvakudzekana, ndingano. We see it as a good thing. It is not a bad thing. Yes, we are living in a world where there are bad things that happen around us. To us, bad things that we do to others, we hurt, we are hurt, or we hurt others and we are hurt by others. But that should not damage or corrupt our thinking, our faith in God and what He teaches about love, marriage, and sex. Even though we might have made mistakes, have done wrong before, but it is something which we must promote, especially also as parents raising up children. Even in this world where even in today's world. Nango holding about this song is something we can sing along and also apply and also learn from it. Amen. Let us pray. Oh Jehovah, our loving and wonderful Father and God, you who reveal yourself in your word that you are love, you are the measure, the standard, the perfect model of what love is. Oh Jehovah, thank you for the Bible. Thank you for this book of Song of Songs. Thank you that we were able to listen to it and read it. Help us to continue reading it, living it, and singing it. Help us in our lives to remember you and to walk with you, to listen to you, and to obey you. Give us faith to trust that your word and what you command and promise is true, and it is good. It is the best. Help us to believe, O Jehovah, even when around us there might be corruption and decay, things falling down, breaking down. Help us to believe, even though it is difficult. As people we sin, we are imperfect. As people we make mistake, we do wrong, we hurt others. But help us to repent. Help us to aspire to what Song of Songs is singing about. Use us, O Jehovah, not only to believe, but also to witness. Bless the marriages. Bless the parents. Guide the youth even in their journey and relationship decisions. We know that, O Jehovah, you can help us. And that's why we trust you. Even where we are hurt because of past experience, people hurting us even as children, help us to be comforted, to be healed. Help us to fight for justice, for security, and that things be according to your arrangement, to your will. We ask, O Jehovah, for all this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.